Welcome back. It's a maritime discovery, more than a century in the making. Check this out,
Incredible.
Folks. Isn't it? That is the hull of the HMS Endurance, the sunken ship of legendary polar explorer Ernest Shackleton, discovered all the way down in the icy depths of the Antarctic Ocean. It's astonishing. Look how well preserved it is. 107 years after it was trapped in ice and sank.
Wow.
Incredible.
It is extraordinary. Well, joining us to discuss and unpack this amazing find is Andrew Kelly, the CEO of the Antarctic Science Foundation. Andrew, what a day in the office for you guys. Seriously, it's incredible.
Good morning, Carl, Sarah. It is incredible. It's the most extraordinary find. This is a real pinch-me moment for anyone who's interested or connected with Antarctica.
How did you locate it? And what is it, in a couple of hundred metres of water?
It's in 3 kilometres of water, Carl.
Whoa.
It's in one of the most treacherous seas in the world, the Weddell Sea, in freezing temperatures. And it's, as you said, it's amazingly well preserved for 106 years.
Well, that's it. You're literally looking at history here.
Yeah.
These finds just don't happen, right? This is years of hard work that's come, and we finally now have a bit more of an insight maybe into what happened. I mean, the story of the HMS Endurance is just amazing. Talk us through it.
Well, the Endurance is the culmination of a lot of preparation from Shackleton to try and reach the South Pole. And when they reached the sea ice, the ship became encased and stuck. And so they decamped from the ship and camped beside it for many, many months, knowing that it was being crushed by the sea. It eventually gave way and sank. And then they mounted an enormous expedition to get the men away from the wreck and the floes. They sailed to Elephant Island and then on to South Georgia. Shackleton rescued every single man in his crew. Not a single person died over the period of this expedition.
So in finding the Endurance, first of all, the kind of condition it is in is remarkable. How did you find it and why is it so well preserved?
Well, the expedition that has found it, Endurance 22, they have been looking to locate and then scan this wreck for many, many years. And the real wonder of what we're seeing last night is that there are no parasites that consume wood in the Weddell Sea. So we are looking at a ghost ship. We are looking at the ship in almost the exact condition as it was when it fell through the ice back 106 years ago. Sorry. It still contains the crockery, the pots, there's even a boot on the ship in exactly the same way as it descended into the sea and then met the sea floor.
And Andrew, there's so much history packed into that ship. Are we able to retrieve it? I mean, how can the public see more of this?
Well, the ship and the site is actually protected under the 1959 Antarctic Treaty, which meant that the expedition team were allowed to look at it. They were able to make a high-definition 3D scan of it, but they were not allowed to touch it. They were not allowed to retrieve any of the artifacts from the site, and that will remain as a sacred site, if you like, for Antarctic history for eternity. And under the Antarctic Treaty, once again, we're seeing a touchstone for humanity. This site is protected, and Antarctica as a continent is protected for both research and science. Okay. Antarctica has never had an armed conflict, so it also remains as a sign of peace and a place of peace in our world. So again, Antarctica is saying to humanity, these are some other ways that we could live.
Definitely. It's getting a little bit busy down there with the Chinese and the Russians as well. So it's a good one to protect, isn't it? Look, just before we go, in all honesty, you look at that and the preservation, when you consider the currents in 107 years, I mean, it's just the mind boggles. What was your first feeling when you saw that vision?
We often say that Antarctica is the greatest library known to humanity. It's full of data and information about how our world was created, and that will inform our future. The problem with that library is that we've barely read any of the books. Last night, we got to read a very important book. The Endurance represents the heroic age of exploration, but it also is an inspiration for the Antarctic Science Foundation and the people and projects that we back to go and look for the answers that will sustain life on this planet.
Very good, mate. Very yeah. well said. We're excited and we didn't have anything to do with it. So well done to you and everyone.
It's just fantastic. Appreciate it.
Yeah, we will from afar.